All right, big day for Brave Wilderness. I'm about to attempt to film the real-life Godzilla on the shores of an active volcano in the middle of the Galapagos. But to do that, I will need to dive under those crashing waves if I want to get up close to the only lizard on the planet that navigates the ocean, the marine iguana. Hostile forces of nature. The famous words of Darwin describe the Galapagos perfectly, and that's exactly what we're up against. Filming marine iguanas in action means we will need to scuba dive through shark-filled waters, avoid ripping ocean currents, and brave relentless tidal surges that will throw us around like ragdolls. All right, so as we make our way to the intertidal zone, you can begin to see what we're going to contend with. As a scuba diver, if we get caught in these breakers, it could be game over, but it's what it's gonna take if we wanna get up close to those iconic marine iguanas. All right, we have to dive deep quickly to avoid the current. All divers on today's mission are carrying emergency GPS beacons in case one of us gets pulled out to sea. It's critical we remain close together as we make our way toward the iguana feeding grounds. Visibility will change frequently, and there will be many twists and turns to navigate. The water here is very cold, only 68 degrees Fahrenheit. It's also high in nutrients, which attracts more than just iguanas. The Galapagos has one of the most biodiverse marine systems on the planet, making it a critical front line of conservation. But there's no time to waste. We need to save as much air as possible to film the iguanas. The surge will only get stronger the shallower we go. It's almost like the ocean is breathing. Push, calm, pull, push, calm, pull. This is the most turbulent water I have ever experienced, and it's making it hard to stay submerged. But surfacing now could roll us into the breaking waves, which would be very dangerous and potentially a life-threatening scenario. Only 50 yards from shore, this is where we need to be. And there it is, our first iguana. What you are looking at is one of the most specialized lizards on the planet, and the only one that spends time in the ocean. The marine iguana. If there were ever a living version of Godzilla, this is it. In fact, one of the common names for them on San Cristobal Island is the Godzilla iguana. Check out that scientific name. It turns out Godzilla is now a real animal. Filming these iguanas is going to be a real test. Luckily, the rocks down here are only covered in plants, so unlike coral, it's okay for us to carefully hold on with our gloves. But the surge is intense, making it nearly impossible to hold on when it rips through. Periods of calm will be our only chance to get close to the iguanas. But make no mistake, the surge will return. Luckily, the iguanas seem laser-focused on feeding, almost ignoring our presence. Clearly, every bite counts when you're braving these conditions. Marine iguanas are herbivores that have adapted many specializations to help them survive at sea for the sole purpose of finding food. The rocks here are covered in a leafy marine salad that includes red and green algae, a favorite of the marine iguana, and one of the only reliable food sources for them in the Galapagos. To get it, They have to sometimes dive 60 feet and hold their breath for up to 30 minutes. They use their hooked, talon-like claws to grip onto the rocks, while their shortened snout allows them to get their teeth closer and into tight spaces to chomp away at the algae. So their Godzilla-like appearance does serve a survival purpose. Marine iguanas have also developed flattened tails that are muscular and help them swim through this hazardous environment. And as much as they need their swimming ability to dive into the ocean, it's the getting back to land when it really comes into play. Unlike us, the iguanas are able to swim right into the breakers and body surf their way back to land. Their ability to navigate the bone-crushing waves is unbelievable. But of course, they saved their final and most impressive adaptation for the shore. Because these iguanas feed on plants full of salt water, they have remarkably evolved glands that absorb the salt to be ejected by way of snot rockets, also called wigs. And while it seems gross, it's very efficient and just another unlikely demonstration of how these iguanas have solved the many problems to exist here in the Galapagos. Contrary to their name, marine iguanas spend most of their lives on land. The shores of Fernandina can be stacked with hundreds of basking lizards, and while only adult iguanas dive for food, you can spot subadults and juveniles foraging in the tide pools or just at the water's edge. Large male iguanas are very territorial and can be seen sparring or using head bobs to push off competing males from the rest of the breeding population. Before they branched off to explore the waters of the intertidal zone, marine iguanas started as a land-based species, only driven below the ocean surface due to what must have been an extreme lack of food. In fact, in the Galapagos today, there are three distinct species of iguana that are all descendants of a common land ancestor, one of which is the rarest lizard on the planet and the one that brought us to the Galapagos in the first place. The interconnection between land and sea is unmistakable in the Galapagos. And as an ambassador for rewild.org, we are working together with the Galapagos National Park to ensure this marine reserve is expanded and remains protected for generations to come. There is no better example to the importance of these two worlds than the marine iguana, which is unique to the Galapagos and the only lizard on Earth that has adapted for life in the ocean. The fact they have evolved to survive these hostile forces of nature is truly incredible.
That was such a fun dive.
Woo! That was the coolest scuba diving I've ever done in my entire life. Took everything we had to stay in position and to roll with the surge back and forth. It was surreal. It was like living inside the cover of a National Geographic magazine. And if you can believe it, there are even rarer lizards on these volcanoes. What you have just witnessed is a scene from the making of our very first feature film. Yes, that's right, Brave Wilderness is making a movie. And in celebration of Earth Day, here are some exclusive first looks. Starting to run extremely low on water. We haven't even hit the volcano yet. This is easily the hardest hike I've ever done.
Somewhere up there is a ridge.
Oh, there it is. Look at that.